हेलो एंड नमस्ते, वेलकम टू अनदर ब्रांड न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ दिस फॉर्मुलाई एंड आई एम योर को होस्ट राहुल। आर गेस्ट फॉर टुडे इज मयंक गोस्वामी, अ गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन। अ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर बाय प्रोफेशन, इज ऑल्सो अ फिटनेस एंथुजियास्ट, एन एंटरप्रेन्योर, बॉक्सर, मेंटर एंड पब्लिक स्पीकर। ही इज एन एजुकेटर एंड हेल्प स्टूडेंट्स डेवलप देयर पर्सनैलिटी। ही इज बीन फीचर्ड एंड रिकग्नाइज बाय मेजर इंडियन न्यूज पेपर्स फॉर हिज टॉक्स। Let's get to know more about him. Hello, Mr. Mayank Goswami.
Hi, Rahul. How have you been?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good.
How are days going these days, man?
I've just been busy with site work, so I'm into real estate consultancy.
Yes.
And it's like since 1.5 months, I have been going up and down to Mulshi, which is there in Pune. Which is like 15, 16 kilometers away from my house. So, yeah, I mean, it's a construction site is a complete chaos, so it takes away my whole day. So today it was like 11 hours of continuous working, and you know, I hardly had like 10 to 15 minutes of break time to have my lunch. So yeah, it was pretty hectic today.
Okay. So I'll directly jump into the questions now. My first question is really very debatic. I still want you to answer that. You were born and raised in Mumbai. You are now living and working in Pune. So which city would you like to retire to?
Okay, that's a very difficult question to answer because there are so many beautiful cities around the world. No, if you don't mind, I would like to, you know, like mention two cities that I would actually, you know, would want to retire. So the first one is in Canada. The place's name is Nova Scotia. It's a very beautiful place. It's like a small island. It's really amazing. You have everything over there: the mountains, the oceans, the beaches, and what else do you need? And the second place that I would like to answer is, you know, I would love to get settled in Pune itself, because even Pune is quite similar in terms of, you know, living in amidst of the nature. Yes, of course you won't have the ocean. The ocean is like 200 kilometers away from here, but still, you know, this city has everything, you know, which a person needs. You know, it has the hills, it has the right kind of people, it has the right kind of companies to work for, it has the right kind of ambience for people to dwell and, you know, take their life ahead, basically. So I have been in love with this particular city since 2009. Like 2009 was the year when I actually shifted to Pune for the first time, and yeah, since then I have been in love with this city. So yeah, why not?
Nice. Let's get on to some serious stuff, man.
Sure.
Yes, according to World Health Organization, more than 264 million people across all age groups suffer from depression. And we are reading about it quite a few days now. It is vital to seek help from mental health professionals. So apart from that, do you think that meditation and physical exercise can help tackle mental stress?
Yes, of course. Physical exercises and meditation go hand in hand. So if you check out habits, not just my habits, like any particular successful guy or girl who is there around you, they will have physical exercise and meditation, which is like a mental exercise, in their daily routines. The reason behind all of these things to work in tandem with each other is because the whole game lies within raising one's vibration. So by vibration, what do I mean is, if you see feelings, depression is a feeling, yes or no?
Yes.
So in the same way, sadness is a feeling, anxiety is a feeling. When we talk about such feelings, they always lie in the low vibrational spaces of our mind. And when a person integrates physical exercise, meditation, even chanting of Om, for example, is just another form of meditation. So when a person integrates all of these things, which at the end of the day increases your vibrations, your vibrational frequencies and put you at in higher vibrational mode, they are bound to help you with all of these things.
So how are you taking care of your mental space in a challenging situation like this? What practices do you follow for your mental health?
So I have been into writing since a lot of years now. Like it's been like 8 years I've been writing. I have been into fitness, I've been into gymming, I've been into boxing. So I started boxing when I was in like standard 7. I did not compete, but I loved the way the whole sport is designed. It is one of the world's most oldest sports to be in existence till date. The whole point of contact sports really attracted me towards it. I naturally gravitated towards that particular sport. That is where I found my first talent, which I had, and I still have, that is ability to express myself physically into a sport.
Okay.
So while practicing, like even while practicing, it gave me such immense amount of satisfaction at the end of the day and at the end of every single practice. Now, I know that you are into football.
Yeah.
At the end of every single game, when you win, what kind of a feeling do you take home?
I'm happy that my team is winning. That's all I...
You're happy, yeah. You're happy that your team is winning.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, you have a sense of accomplishment, right?
Yes.
So this is something which I got from boxing. This is something that I got from gymming. This is something that I got from cycling.
Okay.
So for me, fitness has been a part of my life since a long time. Of course, there was a huge amount of time, like more than 8 years or 9 years, where I was not in touch with my talent of, you know, being physically fit and taking care of myself, and learning new and new things and new tricks in my own sport. But then again, jumping back into that particular field of sport did not even take 2 days for me. It was just a 1 day thing for me to jump back into the same field and then, you know, start off with my fitness journey.
So your fitness journey has been a roller coaster. Could you tell us about it? What made you get into fitness? Do you have a fitness schedule as such?
Yeah, now, if you ask me now, yes, of course, I do have a fitness schedule. So I make a point that every single day when I wake up in the morning. So first thing that I have learned, you know, if you really want to get into fitness, you have to give up the habit of waking up late in the night. That is where your day starts. For me, that is where my day starts. So there were times in my life where I used to just, you know, Instagram hai, Facebook hai, movies hai, Netflix hai, and there are so many other things which we are surrounded can take away that particular habit of sleeping early. Fitness starts by sleeping in early in the first place. Make sure that you are getting that required rest. Biologically, if we speak, the best amount of rest that we get is in between 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. in the night. And a lot of people, I like around me, my friends, my family as well, that even I myself have been into this particular phase of sleeping 1 o'clock in the night and 2 o'clock in the night and then waking up in the morning and then rushing towards my job. But I lost the most productive hours of my day, which is from 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. So what I've started doing is So I wake up by 5:55 or 6 o'clock in the morning, and then I make sure that I'm going in for either 1,000 number of skipping or 15 kilometer of cycling or 100 floors of steps. My building size is like 10, so I do it 10 times on the like inside the same building, so which gives me 100 floors in one go.
Okay.
So you know, there are so many other things, like even if you're not into gymming, you can start your day with an exercise. So starting your day with exercise is like the best thing you can do. And you know, it is like the first grip that you have over your day. Second thing comes in is your breakfast, which is the most important meal of the day. I have been behind my friends to not skip breakfast. And I keep trying to explain them why breakfast is so necessary. So when like after the exercise, when you come back home, I make sure that I have a nice mug of black coffee. Black coffee is my favorite. And after black coffee, I make sure that I am having some of the other fruits which are high in antioxidant properties and as well as they give you strength for the whole day. So this is something that I follow every single day. And then after that, after I take a shower, then comes in the meditation part. So for 15 minutes, I am with myself. And I make sure that for those 15 minutes, I am just, just being myself. That's it. At that time, I'm not a employee. I'm not anyone's son. I'm not anyone's brother. I'm not anyone's friend. I'm just myself. I'm just myself. For 15 minutes, I just experience life as it is, which is very relieving. And I start my day like that.
Okay. So I've seen your passion and love of boxing personally. How did fitness and boxing change your life? Do you still practice it?
Yes, of course, I do practice it. So shadow boxing is something that I practice thrice in a week.
What's that?
So shadow boxing is something like you're standing in front of a light. So basically, I have two balconies at my place. Since the lockdown has taken a lot of months away from a lot of people, like all of us, basically, we had to find ways and techniques wherein we could, execute our workout. For those who are into fitness, basically what I've done is I've made a provision of a light bulb inside my balcony. And when I stand in front of the light bulb, it throws a shadow on the other side of the wall. By observing my shadow, I start practicing my punches, my duck, my jabs, my hooks, my punches. So it's like a 15-minute continuous practice session with my own shadow. So that's like what is shadow boxing. So that is something which is like a whole body workout, a complete body workout, where you are working your thighs, you're working your arms, you're working your back, you're working your shoulders. Even 15 minutes of continuous shadow boxing can pretty much do the trick.
Great. What are your thoughts about boxing in India?
My thoughts on boxing in India, I cannot express how happy I am that, there are organizations and there are people who are ready to fund particular sport in India right now. Because when I was there in my teenagers, when I started boxing and I actually wanted to be in it as a full-time professional, as a full-time pugilist, I always dreamt of being a boxer. Unfortunately, during that time, we did not have those facilities. We did not have that infrastructure. Of course, the army had it. So AIPT in Pune is one of the centers for training in boxing. Then there are a couple of more centers where people can go in. Opportunities are there, but you won't find like during my time there wasn't such a boom of boxers coming into this particular sport and making a career out of it. So I am talking about way back in 2009, 2010, where boxing wasn't considered to be a sport where, people can put their lives into. But now if you see it, the way it is booming, the whole federation is coming up with infrastructure facilities and funding facilities and funding provisions for aspiring boxers. It is very inspiring for me to see. Of course, my time, I'm going to turn 31 in this particular November. Yeah, so for me, like getting back into boxing, it's like a dream now.
Okay.
But yeah, for young people who are like 16, 17, who are aspiring to be into this particular sport, India has a huge potential right now.
Sure. Given a chance, who would you like to compete against?
Given a chance, who would have competed against? Okay. Sylvester Stallone, no doubt. I would want to fight that guy because the way I've seen him in real life as well as in the movies, that guy just doesn't know how to give up. And I want to check my threshold, where will I give up? And even if I will give up or not. But apart from that, I would love to, compete with Vijendra Singh.
Okay.
Yeah, considering the height and the body weight category. Because when I used to compete, I used to compete in super heavyweight, which is like 85 kgs and above. I've always been healthy. So yeah.
Okay. So do you think physical fitness is equally important for a teacher, a general teacher?
Yeah, of course. Like, if we talk about teachers, they have one of the most important jobs on the earth. That is what I feel. Because without a teacher, there will be no student. And without a student, there will be no society.
Sure.
For a teacher, it is of the utmost importance where they need to take care of themselves physically, mentally, emotionally, as well as spiritually. These are the four pillars for every single human being which is present. Teachers are those people on which society depends upon. That is the reason being a teacher is a noble job. So for a teacher to stand in the class for the whole day and to teach students requires immense amount of energy. And apart from that, they have administration jobs. And apart from that, they have papers to check. And apart from that, they have extracurricular activities to take care of. So this becomes a lot of, this becomes a combination of physical as well as mental work at the same time, every single day.
Okay.
So yes, fitness for every teacher is a must.
Definitely. Talking about fitness, we cannot leave behind the good part, which is good nutrition. Nutrition is a core tenet here at Forme.co. What are your thoughts about nutrition? Do you think It's equally necessary along with fitness.
By the way, you know what? Of course, I'll answer this question, but I would really take out some time and appreciate whatever you're doing right now. Running a company for a year and then starting off with your own talk show. You know, it takes an entrepreneurial spirit to move ahead in life. Of course, it's commendable whatever you're doing. So coming back to the question. So without nutrition, fitness cannot exist. Without nutrition, the energy level which is required for fitness, that cannot exist.
Yes.
Without nutrition, you cannot even think of getting up in the morning and going for a jog and, you know, and go out for a jog. Because if you do not have the required nutrition, so for example, if Usain Bolt, the world's fastest, our beloved Usain Bolt, does not have protein intake, will he be able to run the way he runs, sprint the way he sprints?
No, not at all.
Yes. And in the like, and in the same way, let's talk about the common people, right? Because this talk show is about the common man. If you do not take the required proteins, carbohydrates, fats, even fats are necessary
Yes.
in nutrition. They play a very important role. If you do not take a combination of these three at the right time, in the right amount, of course there will be an imbalance. And apart from that, our human body is made in such a way that it won't be able to function properly when it is actually required. So if you are into a job, right? If you're into a job, your manager has asked you a report by the end of the day. And the kind of lethargic feeling that comes in when your boss says, and the kind of demotivation that comes along with it is immense.
Yes.
But if you are right on nutrition, if you are light in your mind and body, you will, without any hesitation, take on to that challenge also, which makes nutrition the most important part of everyone's daily life.
Yes. Contrary to popular definitions, a diet is what you eat on a daily basis. That's what we have read about. What
Right.
would be your diet on a typical day?
So my diet on a typical day, so I make sure that I have 6 eggs every single day, in the morning, 3 in the night. Like 3 in the morning with my breakfast, along with fruits, and then 3 in the night post my workout. So this is the amount of proteins that I take in every single day. Eggs are considered to be wholesome foods. यार संडे या मंडे रोज का वनडे वो बात यही हो जाती है फिर. And apart from that, I also ensure that, you know, I'm taking in carbohydrates in the while I'm having lunch. Me being a vegetarian, my whole family is a vegetarian, so we do not have that particular privilege of having non-vegetarian food at home. Matlab, 5 years I had to take permission from my parents so that I can just could I can't just boil eggs at my place.
अरे बाप
Like can't
रे.
even make a om yeah I can't even make a omelette or a bhurji or something of that sort which tastes really good. All I can
यस.
do is boil eggs, और वो उसका इलेक्ट्रिक गैस भी मैं ही खरीद के लेके आया था. I make sure that, you know, I am stationed at site. A site is like a war zone. 10 different activities are happening simultaneously at the same time, and you have to keep a tab on every single activity. So me being a manager in the company, it is a very difficult role sometimes to, you know, coordinate all of these things at the same time, and then making sure that I'm not missing out on my meal time, because meal time is really important. If you do not have the set of nutrients at a specific time, it is of no use.
Exactly. What would be your favorite cheat meal? I'm sure our viewers must be waiting for this question.
My favorite cheat meal. Okay, so for all those North Indians out there, I know your love. You will always be in love with puri bhajis and kheer and kachoris.
Yes.
So my family actually hails from Vrindavan, which is there in UP.
Okay.
And like I was the one who was born in Mumbai, but my family hails from Vrindavan, which is there in Mathura. Mathura is in UP. So my favorite food, my favorite cheat meal since, like as far as I can remember since birth, has been kheer and kachori and puri and sabzi.
Beautiful.
It only happens thrice or 4 times, max to max 5 times in a year, where, you know, this particular food is prepared at my place. And at that day, fitness कहीं का नहीं रहता है. डाइट कहीं का नहीं रहता है. इट्स जस्ट दैट मी एंड फूड. सो दैट इज माय फेवरेट चीट मील.
ओके. बिसाइड्स न्यूट्रिशन एंड फिटनेस, रिकवरी इज ऑफ प्राइम इंपॉर्टेंस. आवर बॉडी एक्चुअली हील्स एंड ग्रोज ड्यूरिंग स्लीपिंग. डू यू हैव अ स्लीपिंग शेड्यूल?
Yes, I do have a sleeping schedule. I make sure that, you know, my eyes are shut by the clock hits 11:30. And if I have a lot of work in my hands, that is like there are a lot of tasks which we have to do, I make sure 11:30 is the time that I shut every single thing off and then I go to sleep. If I do have my schedule on track, I make sure by 10 o'clock I'm off to bed. So that is like, as I said before, because if you cannot set your sleep cycles at the right time, your body will not be able to recover itself. If your body is not able to recover itself from the last day's workout, how will you run and function the other day?
Yes.
Right? For the body, it becomes very heavy to take on the task the other day. In the night time, sleep is the most important thing you should be also focused on. So I have also noticed this one thing, and even I have gone through the same thing. There has been a lot of times when we set our alarm clocks for early in the morning, for rising early in the morning, but we do not set alarm clocks for sleeping early in the night so that we can wake up early in the morning.
Yes.
Another thing that I have done like with my cell phone is there is an alarm clock just set for sleeping early in the night, so that whatever I'm doing, I may be in some office work, I may be in some writing work, I may be busy talking to someone, I may be busy watching a movie or something. That alarm clock is like it makes you conscious about, okay, it's time, you need to go to sleep because you have a big day tomorrow.
Yes, so you should listen to your body.
Yes, it is very important to listen to your body. And you know what, I'll tell you something. Do not work out the day you do not feel like working out. Do not follow nutrition if you don't feel like following nutrition.
Exactly.
It is all about taking care of your body. Of course, don't make it a habit. Shift it from 1 to 2 days, but not more than that. But always listen to your body, because your body will always respond to what your mind is thinking. And if you don't feel like it, it's better to put your thoughts down for a day or two and then resume with more enthusiasm, more energy the next day.
Okay. As we have talked a lot about fitness and having a good nutrition, I want to ask you that, do you believe that your fitness and a good lifestyle has helped you become what you are today?
Fitness and the kind of lifestyle that I've gained in the recent months has given me the inspiration and the motivation to achieve my goals. In no way it would have been possible for me to be with you on this call if I did not take my fitness and if I did not take my lifestyle choices seriously. It is because of what I have built through these couple of months. The kind of energy, the kind of personality since a couple of months is it's been a little different of what it used to be. So it has played an integral part for me to bring about that particular change. Because I'll tell you, when I was there in Mumbai, so in 2016 I went to Mumbai for my job. I was working with Oberoi Constructions Limited in Mumbai. 2016 was the year where I actually, grabbed the best package of my life. Everything was good. I was living there on my own. I had my own place. I had a high-paying job. I had everything that a postgraduate would imagine. But the only thing which was missing was the energy to do more,
Yes.
which was because of my improper lifestyle choices. If you are in Mumbai, 12-hour job is the normal. So 12 hours given to job, coming back home, cooking my own food, and then going out with friends, then partying, and then coming back, coming to Pune, and then partying here also, and then going back. So I did not have the energy to do more. It's like I was performing on my job. I was the best employee in my team. Being in the construction sector, I had two towers in my control, and those two towers were doing brilliant when I was there. I was performing on my job, but apart from my professional life, I had my dreams to, make them come true, right? I did not have any energy left for working on my dreams. So going into that, no, I have to make better choices. No, I have to sleep early in the night. It became a conscious effort to put in every single day of my life. And this is what made me achieve this particular lifestyle that I am at today. And this is how, even on being on job, as I told you, I had 11-hour shift today.
Yes.
After that, I do have the energy to speak with you for more 2 hours.
Yes. So
So,
getting back
yeah.
to sleeping, how long have you practicing the sleeping schedule?
I have been into practice of my sleeping schedule since 3 months now. It took a lot of time and a lot of tries and attempts to habituate my own body into going to bed early. And then you need to, train your mind. You need to train your thoughts. You need to have a set of before bed practices to calm your mind down. You need to have practices which make the social media stay away before you go to bed, like at least half an hour. Because I know how addictive it can get when I get to bed.
Yes. So very few people know you are a man of multiple talents. You are also a poet. So can you please recite one of your poems for our audience?
Right now?
Yes.
Okay, I would love to. So I also had my own website for my poems back in 2017. For over 1 year, I had more than 100 poems on my website, and I had viewers from all around the world at that time. Okay, so which thought should I go for? I'm actually, searching for a short one which I have written recently.
Please.
Okay, so which one would you like to hear? English one or a Hindi one? Which one?
हिंदी में वर्क टू
ओके, सो इस कविता का नाम है यार क्या कहूँ क्या बताऊँ।
ओके
यार क्या कहूँ क्या बताऊँ आज मन की बात कहता हूँ। यार क्या कहूँ क्या बताऊँ आज मन की बात कहता हूँ। वक्त का पहरा हम सब पर है, वक्त का पहरा हम सब पर है, फिर भी ये जिंदगी की एक बात कहता हूँ। दोस्ती से दरवाजे पर ना विष्णु है ना शिवा, दोस्ती के इस दरवाजे पर ना विष्णु है ना शिवा, फिर भी इस रिश्ते का नाम जिसने भी रखा वो भगवान से कम नहीं था।
वाह wow.
क्योंकि इस दुनिया में उससे बड़ा कोई रिश्ता नहीं, क्योंकि इस दुनिया में उससे बड़ा कोई रिश्ता नहीं। यार क्या कहूँ क्या बताऊँ आज मन की बात कहता हूँ।
रियली ब्यूटीफुल रियली ब्यूटीफुल. डू
थैंक यू सो मच।
यू हैव एनी स्लीपिंग रिचुअल्स?
यस आई डू। As a matter of fact, writing is one of them. So recently, I have got a small diary, started maintaining a small diary, which I have named Feed Your Soul. Before going to sleep, before you end the day, write down 5 to 6 or any number of positive things that have happened with you in that particular day. Not only this particular practice is going to make you express and release whatever negative is there inside of you before you go to bed, but also it will make sure that you'll be able to count whatever good that has happened with you today. And this is one thing that will make you practice gratitude. In our daily lives, so many things we take for granted, so many people we take for granted, we ourselves cannot make a note of it.
Yes.
So this particular practice I've recently started. I'm not, I won't lie. Trust me, since 4 nights, I have been sleeping like a baby. I've
Really?
been sleeping like a baby. This is one of my habits. Second one is putting my phone away for like more than half an hour before I go to bed. I'm either reading or I'm either talking with my mother or talking with my family, or I'm just practicing meditation for 15 minutes again, or I'm chanting Om before going to bed for 15 minutes every single day. So these small things, like initially they will be difficult for you to practice. If you sleep happy, if you sleep content, if you sleep satisfied knowing that your day was worth it, the next morning is going to be really amazing for you. When you wake up in the morning, when you see the sun rising, the kind of feeling, the kind of positive feeling that you will get.
Yes. So we all have a strong influencing factor in our lives. What would you say has influenced you to reach where you are today?
It is that voice, small voice inside of my head that keeps talking to me. Okay, I'm not every single person has a small voice which keeps talking to you when the times you are alone and when you're just being with yourself. There will be a voice which comes from the inside, right? This has been my guiding light since a lot of years. To be very frank with you, I wasn't cut out to be an engineer in the first place. But life did take me through that journey and making me realize certain stuff that, whatever I put my mind to, I set my mind to, I can actually achieve it. Even after failing for 2 years, I'm shameless to talk about my failures. It's like I have no shame. I talk about my failures as if they are my prized possessions, which they are at the end of the day because they have taught me so much in life.
Yes.
Even after failing 2 years in engineering, there was a time when I went to my mom and I told her that, "Mom, I do not wish to be an engineer. This is not my cup of tea." At the end of the day, she got me to consensus that, "Mayank, this is not the way you should be thinking. If you wish to quit, you may as well go ahead and quit. I will not stop you. But at the end of the day, always understand this, that whatever you set your mind to, you can actually achieve." Which is the same thing my inner voice was telling me since a lot of time, and I wasn't ready to listen to it. Mother and father in life then consider yourself really lucky. Mother and father are our first mentors, therefore our first teachers in life.
Yes.
So that was the time when I took her words seriously. And Rahul, I kid you not, trust me when I say this, 6 महीने में 11 सब्जेक्ट निकालना मैं सोच भी नहीं सकता था. मतलब मैं माय माय ओन इनर वॉइस एंड माय ओन लाइक एनर्जी वाज सेइंग टू मी, थिंक आई स्टिल हैव अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ एडीडी, जिससे मुझे फोकस नहीं होता है. स्टूडेंट्स जो दो दो घंटे में अपनी पढ़ाई करके खत्म कर देते, अगर चैप्टर है 2 घंटे में अगर खत्म कर सकते, तो उसी चीज को मेरे को 5 घंटे लगते थे. सो आई टू लिटरली सिट विद बुक्स फॉर 10 आवर्स, 16 आवर्स, इवन 16 आवर्स अ डे, एंड यू नो जस्ट पुट माई सेल्फ इन टू द वर्क एंड नो से टू माई सेल्फ दैट आई कैन डू दिस, दिस इज नॉट ओवर अंटिल आई से इट आई आई क्विट. सो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ एटीट्यूड आई अटेंड एट दैट टाइम, विच हैज मेड मी स्टेप अप टू डू मोर एंड बी मोर फॉर वॉट आई एम.
Okay, I would like you to explain one thing which I have seen. You were featured on One Life, Many Dreams. You speak about consciousness and awareness. You explained a very important difference between those two words in that video. Could you explain it to our audience in a shorter format?
Yeah, sure, why not? Okay, so I'll just give one good example, the difference between awareness and consciousness.
Yes.
Before I give that example, let me tell you what is consciousness and what is awareness. So if I walk up towards you, like if I come to meet you personally, if I come to meet you, if I come from the like अगर मैं पीछे से आके तेरे पे हाथ रखता हूँ और मैं बोलता हूँ हाय राहुल, तो तेरे को समझ में आ जाएगा कि मैं हूँ. बिकॉज यू नो माई वॉइस, योर वॉइस इज माई वॉइस इज रिकॉर्डेड इन योर हेड, राइट? सो यू विल गेट अवेयर ऑफ माई प्रेजेंस एट दैट टाइम. यस, देयर इज माई फ्रेंड मयंक हु हैज कम टू मीट मी. एट द अदर एंड इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट देयर इनसाइड ऑफ यू. इट्स लाइक कॉन्शियसनेस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ यू बट इट लाइज आउटसाइड ऑफ यू. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर जस्ट सिटिंग देयर एंड जस्ट डूइंग योर ओन थिंग एंड आई कम फ्रॉम 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 बिहाइंड एंड आई पुट माई हैंड And I don't say anything to you. If I don't utter anything, what will you feel? You questions will come into your mind that किसका हाथ है, right?
Yes.
Then you will feel a presence of someone. Someone is there behind my back. Consciousness will tell you that there is someone behind your back who knows you. Obviously, if an unknown person does that, you'll slap him. But only friends do that to friends, right?
Yes.
Generally, friends do that to friends.
Yes.
Then you will get conscious about my presence. You won't know who I am. You won't get aware of me being there with you. But of course, जब तू देखेगा पीछे की तरफ मुड़ के, तो मैं तो दिख जाऊंगा. Then
Yes.
you will get aware of my presence here. So Mayank is there.
Yes.
Yes. Right? So this is something, consciousness is our gift. So there is a very thin line difference between awareness and consciousness. Being conscious of a fact that we have limited time in this. Everyone is aware that we are going to die one day, but the day we get conscious about it is the time when we actually start living. You are conscious about the fact that you have limited time in your life. You will jump onto your goals. You'll stop wasting time. You'll stop spending time on social media. And they are good at the end of the day. And
Yes.
also, a lot of people have misunderstood the concept of social media, but that's
Yes.
completely fine. That's just a part of being human.
Mm.
But the time when you actually start getting conscious of your habits, eating the right food, going to sleep early, wake up early in the morning, we are unaware about it. It is only when we get conscious about it, we start taking action.
Beautifully said, man.
Another example I would like to cite. I recently quit my habit of smoking, like 11-year-old habit of smoking.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. I'm really proud of myself, you know, for quitting that habit of cigarette smoking, which I got when I was like 17 years of age. And it was really difficult for me. A couple of months, it was really difficult. You know, I used to start sweating in the middle of the night because body doesn't know, right, that you're trying to quit. Body has its own needs. So body, of course, it doesn't know that particular person is trying to quit. So it will start reacting in ways that you have never experienced before. The same happened with alcohol. There was a time when, you know, I used to drink daily. Like daily, I needed some amount of alcohol to go to sleep, and which was like a habit. So quitting that habit also made a huge difference in my life. And then, so as we spoke about awareness and consciousness, I was aware about it, but my mind was playing tricks on me and it wasn't letting me quit those habits. It was only when I got conscious about them, I learned to train my mind. I learned to fool my mind, saying no at the right times, saying no at the right times. That is what made my willpower grow. And then my willpower dominated every single bad habit that was there inside of me. And that's how I changed.
We are aware that every teacher was once a student. Now that you are a teacher yourself, what advice would you give to younger Mayank, considering he's a teenager?
Fail. Do not be afraid of failure. This is one advice that I would love to give to my younger self. It's completely fine to fail in relationships. It's completely fine to fail in academics. It's completely fine to fail in sports. It's completely fine to fail in every single thing of your life. Make sure whatever failure is showing you, you learn from it. Learning from the failure is the other side of the same coin.
True.
So this is one thing that I would like to tell my younger self. Second, do not go for that first cigarette. Yeah, it might just for trying, just because your friends are doing it, you know, will take it, or just to look cool. I don't know even if that is applicable anymore, because nobody looks cool when they have a cigarette in between of the two fingers. Do not go for that first cigarette. You know, that's one thing that I would always recommend to my younger self. And third, whatever that is I was thinking about myself, I will not be able to check if it is right or wrong without becoming a doer from a thinker. A thinker will always spend a lot of time in their own mind, in their own head. But a doer is someone who would go out and do it, failed, okay, fine, no, so this is not something which is for me, or this is not the way to do it. He'll find another way to do it, the same thing in some other way, but he will come up with that particular one way wherein, for being successful in life, you have to switch from becoming a thinker to a doer.
As we are
Because
already in this deep conversation, if you could sum up your philosophy in one quote, what would it be?
if I would sum up my philosophy in one quote, okay, that's quite difficult, yeah, come on, because philosophy is so vast, you cannot just sum it up in one line. But I'll try, though, I'll try, I'll try. This is one of a challenge now. Yeah, of course, because I haven't done it myself, but I will gladly try and do it. I would love to put my philosophy in one line in the following words. It is completely fine to not know things in life, but it is definitely not okay to not do new things in life. Yeah.
Tell me, what is your definition for success or being successful?
Definition of success. So I'll tell my definition of success. I'll share my definition of success, which I have recently come to consensus with and understanding with. Success is not something which one is looking out to achieve. Success is not a materialistic thing, a spiritual thing, or, you know, a physical thing which is out there to be grabbed. You know, success, it does not lie outside of you. Success actually lies inside of you. Success is actually a state of mind which can be achieved daily. It has to be achieved daily. If you really wish to be successful in whatever that you are doing or you wish to do, you need to start practicing to be successful every single day. So basically, it all comes down to practicing successful habits to build successful days one by one, so that you can have a successful month. And then building 12 successful months to build a successful year, and then building 10 successful years to build a successful decade. This is very fundamental and this is very basic that I'm getting to. This can be applied to anything that you do.
Perfect answer for my question. You have experienced both failure and success in your career. If
Yeah.
failure was a person, what would you say to
Come and get me, bro.
it?
This is what I would say. Come and get me. Okay, if failure was a person, what would I? If failure was a person, what would I say to them? I would say people need you as much as they need success, because without you, there will be no meaning for success, and without success, there will be no meaning for you. You will always be the measure of a man's success. Everyone loves to hear success stories. You are the one who is undershadowed. It is because of your presence people can be successful in life.
Great. How do you stay productive in your professional life? Are there any tools or apps you use that simplify your life?
Yeah, so there is a rule that I've recently started following, and this is applicable to all of people who are there outside listening to this podcast, because there are people who have bursts and spikes of energy where they will go on to their desk and complete whatever is there in one go, and then, you know, they just chill for the day. And there are people who would start their work at 9 and finish at 5, and even after that if they have a lot of work. So I always follow this one rule of 90-20 minute. It's like 90 minutes I try to stay focused on my work, I keep checking my clock for 90 minutes. For those 90 minutes, I promise myself that I'm not going to deviate from my work. So whatever work, difficult task or an easy task, whatever it is, like in your professional life, in your day-to-day life, make sure you are working for 90 minutes in one go, and then take a break of 20 minutes. Do whatever. Go to social media or play a game of chess. I play a game of chess for 20 minutes when I'm there. Of course, when my boss is around, I'm not there on cell phone. I'm doing something else. But in those 20 minutes, I'm reading something which is building my knowledge base, going onto the internet, searching, watch news if you want for 20 minutes, and then come back again. After 20 minutes, come back again and continue for 90 minutes of work again. So this is something which I follow. Second habit I have been following since a lot of time, since the time I've started working. So my first job was when I was 17 and a half years of age in Mumbai for Hewlett Packard, HP.
Okay.
So at that time, I used to have night shifts because it was a US process. So every single 2 hours, my back used to hurt because of, continuously sitting on the chair and taking calls and going through manuals and, helping out people who are sitting in America. In young age, it took a lot of toll on my back. My lower back used to be sore all the time. So what I started practicing is every single, so for people who have, a job of continuously sitting on the chair and working on the laptop, or continuously sitting on the chair and talking with people, practice stretching every 2 hours of your job. You get up from the chair, take a little walk to the cooler or to a vending machine or outside the office, stretch a little bit, and then come back and then resume work. Keep doing this for like every after 2 hours. So it ensures that your back is in proper health while you're working, because your back is really important.
Yes. So as we are ending, I have a fun part which is rapid fire. And
Sure.
you know the rules.
Shoot.
You just have to name the answer in one word. Favorite inspirational movie.
Rocky.
Wow. Favorite inspirational song.
Don't You Worry, Child by Alesso.
Beautiful. Favorite boxer.
Mangoswamy.
Okay. Favorite food.
Eggs.
Favorite exercise?
Shadow boxing.
Okay. Favorite book?
How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie.
Okay. Current book you are reading?
Elon Musk.
Oh, wow. Nice. My last question to you in this podcast is, what are your upcoming plans in near future?
I have been planning to express whatever wisdom, whatever knowledge, whatever experience I've had, in some or the other form through my videos or through my classes, like going out of my house in front of an audience and saying it in front of them, expressing it in front of them. So I would be finding a way to how to sum every single thing up in one single basket. Whatever I have learned until now, whatever I have gained through my failures, whatever experiences that I've had, whatever good times that I have had in this, journey of gaining wisdom and being philosophical and being a teacher and like getting into fitness, being my own mentor for learning new things every single day of my life, and mastering the art of writing. I've just been planning to come up with a book. Simple.
Wow.
All this while, I had it in front of me and I wasn't able to see it.
Okay. Thank you so much. It was really nice to have you on our podcast. I'm sure our viewers and listeners have gained a lot of knowledge by listening to this podcast. I plan to make another podcast with you in the future.
That will be, first of all, I feel really grateful because coming up to a show and expressing my views, sharing my thoughts and my experiences is something I dreamt quite recently. And this has been happening for me. So I know that my universe is working for me. And this gives me immense amount of satisfaction, contentment, joy, happiness. I've got it all. So I know how I'm going to sleep at night. One more point to add tonight. So yeah, and I'm really looking forward for the next one, because there is still so much more that I have to express and to give to people that who are listening to this particular podcast, and as well as the people who would come across this particular piece of art. Thanks a lot, Rahul. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'll be linking all of Mayank's social media handles in the description. Make sure you check them out. And for more content like this, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening. Stay fit, stay happy.